Ja, velkommen til mit haveprojekt. Yes, hello and welcome to my garden railroad start out. I think we have a Danish politician who used to say that the ice are melting by the poles. So I'm going to obviously because I want to get out to as many people as possible. I'm going to make this train layout explanation in English, and that's because I think it's a funny hobby, and as many people as possible has to get the chance to make trains. So what I'm going to show you is how I have started out making my railroad. First off, I started to buy some G-scale LGB tracks for my layout, and later I realized that I'm not going to use them, but I use them for preparation when I'm drawing my schematics and to lay it out on the floor just to see if it fits. So this is my first board of garden railroad train. I also have met some people at Facebook in a Facebook group for garden railroad, and a friendly man called Pierre has lent me a transformer. So I have bought 15 meters of straight line and some arid train tracks. I also bought just for my boy a LGB train, as you can see here. He actually think it's quite nice that his father likes to play with trains. And this is here I'm doing the magic. This is actually the first drawing when I one evening in the winter was thinking about making a railroad in the garden. Obviously it doesn't work. You can see it's like a child drawing. But then I tried to make this drawing and I could see it looked just like something I would like to have in the garden. I'm going out later to show you how it actually look in the garden. This is the outline drawing, because I have to make 20 centimeters garden bed. I don't know what it's called in English. I have to lever the tracks. And as you can see, it's quite difficult for a new man to make the drawings. So I bought a program called SCAM, and this is here. And then I just draw my layout in SCAM. I also made the level showing in the program so that I can go to 3D and watch my layout. As you can see here, it's going up to 20 centimeters. This one is in 20 centimeters level above ground, and this is around in the garden. Oh, and this here, I'm going to 30 centimeters over here. So this is 30, this is 20, and this over here is 70, is 0, sorry. And that is going to be called module 1. From what I have been reading on the internet, it is easy to get frustrated and give up on making the train tracks, because it's quite a big job to do it in a garden. This is 80 square meters, and the total layout, just as a so I know where I'm going with my garden. I have not built the entire tracks. For example, this is just to show that there's going to be a area to get wagons and stuff. And as you can see, this is the top circle, and going over to the station here, and there's maybe, I think there's going to be a station here too, and then all the way around in the garden. So, but I would like to show you how it looks outside and what I have bought and how I'm going to make this railroad possible for me. So now we're out in the garden. It's quite windy. I hope you can hear what I'm saying. And I'm going to show you how my garden is looking. It looks quite messy at the moment. I have started to, first of all, I had to move a lot of bricks, or what you call it. I have about 4 or 5 tons of them. That's a big job. And this is going to be where the circle, the big circle, should be here, and the station over there. Over there, I have to remove all of this before I can have my layout. I even have to remove this little toilet shelter I built, just because we have a lot of burglary where I live, and they don't seem to want to break into the toilet, so I keep it for my tools. And actually, I found a nice old lady on Facebook who had a lot of bridge she wanted to give away. I think there is around 2 or 3 tons. It's going to be the outer ring of the garden bill. Still don't know what it's calling. And this is just concrete to the back side. It's going to be digged down to in the ground, so it won't be able to see them. They're also quite old and not so nice to look at, so I think it's a good way to do it. So, and this is my little house, garden house. I live in Denmark. This is my boys. He actually had said it's okay to make a way to a train station for the trains and nights. So I think they are going in there. This is all of it. Let's see how it goes. Yeah, and actually the trains are going to go from this side and all the way around down there, down to the kitchen, outdoor kitchen, around back of the house, and it's going to get over here. And I have a dream about making a station 2 here too. And all, of course, all of this is having to go away. So yes, thanks for watching. And if you want to be able to see how my train layout is going to work out, you could subscribe to my channel. I think it will be an easy way to get some follow-ups. I'm going to make a video, I hope once a month, and showing how the work is going. I also is going to take some pictures and explain how I'm doing the different kind of stuff. Maybe you can get inspired to do your own. So thanks for watching.